Now, we said that reactions are normally Zeroth Order, First Order, and Second Order. And what we should realize is, with each one of these orders, we're going to have what's called an a rate equation, or an integrated rate law equation. Now, we're going to say for Zeroth Order, First Order, and Second Order, they have the same variables. We're going to say AT represents the final concentration or final amount of our reactant. We're going to say A sub O or A sub naught equals the initial concentration of our reactant. We're going to say K is the same K we've been dealing with. It's the rate constant. And then T is just time. Now, one thing we should realize here is that when it comes to K and T, they have to have the same units of time. So what does that really mean? That means, let's say our time was in hours. K and T have to have the same units of time. So K would have to be hours inverse. So always keep an eye out for that. Make sure they're both the same units of time. If not, you have to convert one so that they both match. Now we're going to say with each one of these orders, there comes a graph. And we're going to say anytime we plot a graph, it's of y versus x. So our y axis is this, and our x axis is this. For all of them, the x axis will always give us time. And we're going to say here that the y can either be concentration of our reactant, ln of our reactant, or 1 over our reactant. And what you should realize is that each one of these integrated rate law equations can be used to write out this plot. So we'll see how that works. So we're going to say these are all the integrated rate law equations. And all of these equations are equal to y equals mx plus b. And what you should realize, we're talking about plotting y versus x. So this first one is zeroth order. Here the y is just the concentration of our reactant, which is right here, the y slope. And x is time. We're going to say m. Remember, m is your slope. And here, remember, your slope is equal to your variable k. So just remember that. It's going to become important later on when we're doing certain types of calculations. Here, on the y-axis, it's ln of my concentration. Here, y is ln of our concentration. And here again, x is time. Then finally, for second order, one thing you should realize first is that second order is the only one with a positive slope. Why is it the only one with a positive slope? Because here, m is a positive k. For zeroth and first order, k was negative. See, it's negative here, and it's negative here, which means the slopes are decreasing over time. Here, y is 1 over a, and of course, time again is on the x-axis. So just remember, we can manipulate these integrated rate laws to basically match them up with y equals mx plus b. And in that way, we can plot y versus x. And remember, your slope, which is m, is equal to your rate constant. Finally, first order, zeroth order, second order. They each have what we call a half-life equation. So remember, half-life is basically the time it takes for about half of a substance to decompose over a period of time. For zeroth order, it is half-life equals the initial concentration of my reactant divided by 2k. For first, it is half-life equals ln 2 over k. And remember, ln 2 is the same thing as 0.693 over k. And then finally, half-life of a second order is 1 over k times the initial concentration. Now, on your exams, your professors will most likely give you these equations, but they'll just mix up the orders. I'd recommend just memorizing them, because if they're going to mix up the orders anyway, you should know which is which. So these are the equations you need to remember when it comes to Zeroth Order, First Order, and Second Order. We'll learn when exactly do we use them and how do we have to manipulate them sometimes to solve for a given question. So just remember, try your best to memorize each one of them, because you most likely will need all of them for your upcoming exams.